Diksha here, and today we are in conversation with Dr. A.B. Thomas, who is the director of Adani Institute of Infrastructure Management. Welcome, sir, to the video series.
Thank you.
So today, guys, we're going to be talking about, you know, you've been preparing for all your interviews and what and how. Here we have sir who's coming with 30 years of teaching and, you know, academic experience. So let's understand from him as a panelist, what all do they look for in a student's profile or a student before coming for an MBA college?
Let it be a student or an employee, what I am looking for a person for employment.
Okay.
It's basically three basic attributes I am looking for. One is the commitment of that particular person. Okay. Commitment to the course.
Yes.
Okay. And second one is the clarity of thought.
Okay.
Clarity of thought, I hope you understand what is the meaning of clarity of thought. Okay.
So, what would it mean for someone?
Whatever issue you are discussing or you are coming across, you should have a clear understanding about of the thought process which is going on in your mind.
Okay.
And third important aspect which I will look for is perseverance of that particular person. Okay. How keen he is for achieving that particular thing. How consistent he is putting his effort. So these are the three basic attributes which I am.
Okay, so commitment, clarity of thought, and perseverance. So if as a student, I have to showcase this, who's coming before to an admissions college, I can give examples of this done in my past. Does that help to, you know, show that yes, this person is perseverant and hardworking?
See, when it comes to commitment, you should have a clear understanding what you are going to do, how committed you are.
Okay.
For example, if you are looking for a management education, generally, people look for a very good quality. What is that entrance examination is known as?
CAT.
No. What is the generic name?
Aptitude test.
Okay. So, when it comes to a management education, the first thing we look at a particular person is how good he is at his aptitude. Okay. So, aptitude cannot be developed over a short period of time. So, you have to consistently work for developing your aptitude, and then you should prepare for the aptitude and then get a very good score. Okay. That is one thing. And consistency, when I say consistency of that particular person's performance right from the beginning. Okay.
So the entire past.
Okay, entire past. It's not only for the school education or for the higher secondary education or for their college education.
Correct.
If you look at the profile of a particular person, you can understand how consistent and how committed
he is.
Yes. Okay. So, when you look at the performance of the student in the graduation, few of the students are getting very less marks or grades in first 3-4 semester, and then they will realize that I have lost the track, and then he will be picking it up.
Okay. Yes.
So to some extent, his consistent performance also matters a lot.
Okay. So since we are talking about this, sir, like academics, all of them. How about having extra activities like extracurricular courses, internships, leadership positions?
You see, management education is making a student capable of dealing with people, primarily.
Okay. Yes.
Apart from his understanding about the management theory, he should also know how to manage the situation. Okay.
Correct.
Managing a situation means managing the people, managing the team, managing the organization. So, whatever you do in your internship or any extracurricular activities, fundamentally what you are doing is you are managing a situation and managing a group of people. Okay.
Correct.
That will definitely add to your quality of education.
Thank you. That's very good. So guys, you know, when you're looking at someone who's with 30 years of expertise, so make sure you are relating your examples to showcase commitment, consistency, clarity of thought. And sir, a lot of these days you see management institutes are encouraging social work and volunteering. So do you think students having some kind of that done in the past adds value?
Definitely that will add value. What I was telling is people management.
Correct.
Whenever you engage into a social work, okay, there also you are you are getting engaged with people. And you know, in life, nothing is going waste. Okay, whatever life experience you are getting,
true,
at one point of time, that will be useful to you. Okay, so generally students think that only academics is going to play a big role in their life. It is not like that. Okay?
It's all the experiences.
It's a holistic. What is, after all, what is education? Education is for the holistic development of a person. So any experience, okay, we generally in education we call it as student experience in the institute.
Yes.
It is not academic experience in the institute. Okay, so students' experience will cover academic, curricular, non-curricular, social engagement,
all
put together.
And that all makes the person who you are, which is there. That's really nice. And I think I read that somewhere on your quotes as well, that good decisions come after, you know, the experiences you learn, so you become better decision makers as well. So that's very interesting. So sir, you've been into this entire 30 years and this entire institute, which is a little different when you talk about infrastructure management. So what makes it that different?
You see, I'm basically an engineer, okay? Later on specialized in engineering management area, especially project management area. Okay, so I have almost 30, 32 years of experience in teaching project management in engineering,
wow,
and management students. Okay.
That's a lot.
Okay. And this institute, Adani Institute of Infrastructure Management, actually we are having two schools in our institute. One is Adani Institute of Infrastructure Engineering and Adani Institute of Infrastructure Management. Okay. Infrastructure management is a very special niche kind of management domain where we are basically training the student to manage the complex and risky infra business. Okay. Unlike general business environment, infra environment is very complex in because of the very unique behavior of the infra business. Okay. The project horizon is very high, the investment cost is very high, risk involved are very high. So to manage that kind of complex business scenario, you need a slightly different kind of management training. Apart from the conventional, the functional management aspects. Okay. For example, the entire infra management or the infra business is a regulated business. So a lot of legal and regulatory management of the business is to be done. Okay, and that become, at one point of time, that become the key for the success of the business. So training the general management student some amount of legal and regulatory aspects is also very important. Okay. And the general finance and infra finance is completely different. The kind of finance management required in infra finance is completely different.
Because a lot of risks and
risk,
high investments.
So this is a special kind of management education where quite a good amount of domain knowledge is also required for, after all, what you are going to manage. You are going to manage a particular business which is having a high input of engineering as well as other things. Okay.
So is it necessary for someone who's coming to infrastructure management to have an engineering background or even the
need not to be, but definitely if you want to do an infra management business, you should have the understanding about the process involved in that business. Okay. If it is a, for example, a power company.
Yeah.
Okay. So the various process involved in the power generation, at least the basic understanding about the power generation and the implication of a process on that particular business
is important to understand. Okay, so that's really interesting. Thank you, sir, so much for your time and insights. It's a great pleasure to, you know, understand and know from you what all things. And just to summarize for all of you guys who've been listening throughout is focus on three things: your clarity of thought, your commitment and consistency, and your perseverance. If you can showcase that to any panelists, that should help you make the cut through all the interviews. So thank you so much, sir. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.